Indians are known for the unity in diversity. The uniqueness of the Indian citizens have been vivid in times of a state and national disaster, be it natural or human induced. The COVID-19 pandemic has forced governments across the world to take unprecedented measures like nationwide lockdown to combat this deadly coronavirus outbreak. Responding to the emergency, Indian government also took this step of nationwide lockdown on 22nd March 2020. On the one hand, people welcomed this nationwide lockdown, but on the other, they also raised concern about the victims of this lockdown, especially the daily wage earners and the migrant workers. While some leaders and critics pointed out to the lack of the preparedness of the government before the announcement of this lockdown, some NGOs, institutions and people of goodwill plunged into action. They began to help the poor and migrant workers of their localities by providing them with food kits. The Explorer, a YouTube channel, brings to you one such noble initiative of a few people of goodwill, their partners, collaborators and volunteers.
The lockdown relief work, operating from St. Joseph's College, Bangalore from 24th March 2020, is an initiative of few socially conscious individuals and their partners.
We are not an NGO. We are a group of individuals who have gotten together in a time of crisis to help people. As a group of individuals, we're doing this from purely a humanitarian perspective.
Father Guntipalli called me saying that Aparna and Vishal, they have come forward with the relief related work, but that we can give the space as such and volunteers also. Imagine if everybody runs away from the reality as such, then we can't do anything. So our desire was, let's do everything possible within our limitations. So that was the beginning.
This whole initiative really started with this lady called Saraswati, who runs Diyaghar. What happened was, when the school shut down, she started getting concerned what will happen to the nourishment of these children. So she went into the community with her teachers to figure out what was happening with them. And then she found actually not only their households, but their neighboring households, and these whole communities were in very, very sorry state. So she quickly repurposed her organization to handle relief works.
There was fear all around. All the more, when Father Francis asked for me for the venue, the first thing came to my mind was service. What's the use of putting this entire infrastructure under lock and key when our people are suffering and they are most in need?
This noble cause got the support of many people of goodwill, NGOs, institutions and companies.
And we joined hands with the team who was, you know, Aparna. I do consulting and training, so I know her through the connections of training and consulting, but also because in the area of service and volunteering. So we were able to engage a lot of volunteers, get funds, get the process in place and get this in a large scale. That's how I got engaged.
As I am working with all my slum dwellers, I am basically a slum dweller, working with them. So it made me to understand that, okay, what is the need of the hour? What is it is needed now? And when Father Francis Guntapalli called me and told about this, I was very much happy about it. Okay, someone has immediately started doing something. It is a very great help, which we started before the government could start.
Voluntarily, we want to help, because if everybody sits at home, then what will happen to needy people? So we give food for them, we arrange everything for them, so they don't suffer like others.
My friend who studies in the social work department in St. Joseph's told me about this relief work which has been happening over here. And I joined a week ago. It's giving hope to a lot of people in these times where there's so much fear around.
Just we came and we started to do some 3-4 days for of us, and then the community felt that it's a very noble work, because being bound by a lockdown and a fear, and you stay inside, you come back here, you find that is a lot of a life where you can serve the people really.
They are doing it for the society, and as the Josephite slogan goes, if you are ever in trouble, a Josephite will come and help you out. So I'm very happy that Josephites are doing this. Without expecting anything from the college, and I am a proud Josephite. Thank you.
Seeing the people, they are locked down instead of wasting time in the home watching TV, and it's better to come and help here. And we many people required us to come and do some work.
Looking at so many volunteers here, and especially the lay people who are coming forward to give their time and energy, that was a big challenge for me, being a religious. If they can do, why not me? So that's why I volunteered wholeheartedly, and I decided to join very freely.
My parents are very strict. They were like, don't go, don't go. So, but then still I resisted myself, because if I sit at home, it's waste of time. So if I come here, I'll do something for myself and for others.
And since it's for a good cause, so we are really like, we want to work. We have that, that desire to work here, that zeal to work here, exactly.
The beauty of our work is one of collaboration. We collaborate with the government and non-government agencies, our present staff and students, alumni and alumni, and of course, the benefactors and good wishes. I'm really grateful to all the people of Goodwill.
Everyone who joined hands to do this good work not only took a reasonable risk, but also made a sacrifice of their time from being with their loved ones.
When these students approached their parents to come here to serve the poor, there was opposition. Opposition out of love and concern for their own children. However, our students took a risk. And some of them, such a risk, they don't even go home. They stay in a hostel and serve every day and night here. And some of our girl students, they stay in the organizers' houses and come here and work and serve the people here.
When somebody feels, what's the problem? So they do not use the mask, or in the process of doing the work, you forget about what needs to be done. So that way we require a kind of a constant reminder. So that is why we used to have a kind of a review meetings, how the things are going on, is there any irritants are there, so that we can address the things and proceed accordingly.
Many individuals, NGOs, companies and institutions have been generously contributing to this noble venture.
We didn't have much money. What happened was they pooled the resources. Saraswati was running an institution for children. She was able to contribute that money that she had, and Aparna had her own personal money for something else, to construct something, and she said, this is a time that we need to contribute, and therefore they contributed.
And this is something my mother taught me, that if you can't put your own money behind it, then there's no point asking others for money. So I made a very, very modest contribution towards this, both from my side and my mother's side as well. And my son also wants to now contribute, so I'll kind of make sure that he makes the payment.
We work with multiple people, multiple NGOs. Some of them are CIFAR, Seed India, Freedom Project, Development Focus. So we work with multiple people. We have received funding from multiple people, including Rotary, the Azim Premji Foundation, and philanthropists and individuals from actually across the world. So we are using the funds to buy material from the market, from wholesalers, dealers directly. Rice is coming directly from the mills. Potatoes is actually coming directly from the farmer. And it's all coming in to be redistributed from this hub.
See, funding has been worked out by multiple NGOs. Like, as you may be already aware, XLRI alumni is a great backbone of this entire operation. Aparna and Vishal, along with the, you may be knowing that Asirudhala Nalini, and there are other NGOs like Diagar or Safa. So these are the ones who galvanize the resources. Every day, as I hear, maybe 10 to 15 lakhs worth of things have been brought, then they are going out. So our concern is what way it reaches to the particular target group.
I'm the president of something called the XLRI Alumni Association in Bangalore. And over the years, we've done a lot of community work, and we've done a lot of other work also, which gave us access to funds. So we had some good amount in our account. So I asked the committee to kind of decide how much they like to donate towards making food kits. And they then said maybe one third of the funds initially. Now they've given two thirds of the funds.
teamwork and decentralized responsibilities have made the work smooth and efficient.
My job is seeing what can be done in terms of what is being procured, what needs to be procured, how much is needed for tomorrow, forecasting, and so that, you know, people don't go out of job.
As far as I'm concerned, I manage the distribution out of the hub. So all the material that comes in, the material that we buy through our fundraising efforts, all the material is accounted at the hub.
As a coordinator of the volunteers of the relief work, it was my responsibility to bring in all the volunteers, all the hands on the deck as possible. I got students from different walks of life.
We also go to distribution, where we distribute ration to a lot of people. So that's a different experience when you distribute a ration to people.
We are going to various orphanages and things where we are giving the kits. So people from other like a normal middle class people vehemently come and take the items from us, which is not fair. Our main motive is the kits what is being done here should reach the people who aren't getting anything.
In spite of difficulties and hard work that this relief work demands, the volunteers have an enriching experience in rendering their valuable service to the poor and migrant laborers in the city because of the nationwide lockdown.
The situation where it comes in COVID-19, most of the families are running out of food and other stuff. So we would like to help them through our basic time what we have.
Yes, I definitely feel happy about it. Mostly we come in around 15 to 25 tons of load, uploading and downloading every single day. But the thing is, when we do it together with all our friends and with the music especially, I think it's energetic and I feel.
But we don't have passes. We have just personal passes to come, but we don't have vehicle passes. In order to just help them and help the society, we have come here as a Josephite.
I'll tell you about my travel experience. Starting few days, I didn't get my pass. For people who are telling that we are doing this for only for the photo or video purpose, that video is the only thing which is helping me to reach my home safely.
I feel it is good when we help some other people. I feel good that I keep in my mind that this is my work, this is only for me.
We just post all these videos, everything, not because we are not popularizing or something. It's because people want to know like we are doing this work, and even they can contribute to us like doing a volunteer or something.
It's a good experience what we are having. It's one-time experience which we won't get even in future. But at the end of the day, everyone is responsible, even people who are staying in the home also, because their job is to stay home and stay safe.
ಇವತ್ತು ಒಂದು ದಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಕ್ಕಿ ಕೊಡಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬ ಬಡವರು ಮನೆಯೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ಬೇರೆ ಇದು ತಾರ್ಪಾಲ್ ಹಾಕ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂಥವ್ರ ಗತಿ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಯಾರಿಗೂ ನೋಡೋರಾಗ ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಂಥದ್ದು ನಾನು ನೋಡಿರೋದು ಒಂದು 50-100 ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಇರೋ ಬದಲು ಕಾಯಿಲೆ ಬಂದರೂ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಪರವಾಗಿಲ್ಲ ಆದರೆ ಇಂಥ ಜಾಗಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋದಾಗ ನಾವು ಸಹಾಯ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ದೇವ್ರು ನಮ್ಮನ್ನು ನೋಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾರೆ
We NSS volunteers are like 20 to 25 number. We work here putting dal, salt, everything and packing it and resending it to the people who are in need.
The work here is a bit tough for us, working from morning to night. But even though we love the work, as well as the other difficulties what I faced is because even though I have a bike, I'm not able to come by because I don't have a pass. So because of it, I walk every day nearly 3 kilometers from my home to come here.
ಆಕಡೆ ಒಂದು ಚುಚ್ಚ ಜೋಬಡಿನ ಹಾಕ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅವರು ಜೀವ ವಹಿಸ್ತಾರೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಅನ್ನನೂ ಸಿಕ್ಕಲ್ಲ ಊಟನೂ ಒಂದು ಹೊತ್ತು ಊಟಕ್ಕೆ ಕಷ್ಟ ಐತೆ ಆ ಥರ ಜಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋದ್ರೆ ನಮಗೇ ಕಣ್ಣಲ್ಲಿ ನೀರು ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಏನಪ್ಪ ಇವ್ರಿಗೆಲ್ಲ ಯಾರು ಗತಿ ಅಂತ ಈ ಕಡೆ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟು ನೋಡಿಲ್ಲ ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ಬೇರೆ ಯಾರನ್ನೂ ಬಂದು ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡೋರಿಲ್ಲ ಈ ಸಂಜಯ್ ಸಬ್ ಕಾಲೇಜಿಂದ ಈ ವಾಲಂಟ್ರಿ ಅವರು ಎತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಬ್ಬೊಬ್ಬರಿಗೂ ಅದು ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಅವ್ರು ಓಡ್ ಬರೋದು ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ನಮಗೆ ಒಂದು ಇದಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಏನಪ್ಪ ಜನರು ಊಟ ಉಣ್ಣಕ್ಕೂ ಊಟ ಇಲ್ವಲ್ಲ ಇವರಿಗೆ ಇವರು ಹೆಂಗೆ ಬಾಳ್ತಾರೆ ಈ ಜಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ತುಂಬ ಕಷ್ಟದಲ್ಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಹುಡುಗರು ಆ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಮರಿಯನ್ನು ಹಿಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಂದು ಆ ಕ್ಯೂ ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾರೆ ಒಬ್ಬೊಬ್ಬರು ಒಬ್ಬ ಮೇಲೆ ಬಿದ್ದು ಅಷ್ಟೂ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೊಡೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಇದ್ರೂ ನಮ್ಮಂದ ಎಷ್ಟು ಕೊಡೋಕ್ಕಾಗುತ್ತೋ ಅಷ್ಟಿಂದ ಇವ್ರು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ
ದ ಗುಡ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಡನ್ ಯರ್ ಡಿಡ್ ಡ್ರಾ ದಿ ಅಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಗವರ್ನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ದಿ ಒಫಿಷಿಯಲ್ಸ್ ಈವನ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಅ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ದೆಮ್ ಇನ್ ಕೋವಿಡ್-19 ರಿಲೀಫ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಟೇಕನ್ ಬೈ ದ ಗವರ್ನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ
The top government officials visited our campus. For example, Major Pradeep Arya, who is a chief coordinator appointed by the government of Karnataka for COVID relief work. Mr. Lakshminarayana, who is the advisor to the Karnataka's chief minister. Mr. Bhaskar Rao, the Bangalore City Police Commissioner. The government officials were very happy and highly appreciated the work done by the college. So much so, they told us whether we could extend a helping hand to the government by preparing ration kits to the government and distribute to the poor.
The organizers feel a sense of contentment and satisfaction as it has achieved more than its initial target because of the generous collaborators and their contributions.
It's absolutely amazing to see so many people get together, like-minded individuals who care about what is going on and come together to alleviate the suffering of people, because most of the food that we're trying to give out is to the poorest of the poor, daily wages, etc. So it's a sense of absolute fulfillment and joy. That's all I can say.
As on today, that is 17th of April, we at St. Joseph's College, we have procured 33,134 food kits for the people in and around Bangalore, especially the slum dwellers and the poor people. With the collaboration of various NGOs, as well as Jesuits of Bangalore, as well as sisters and student volunteers, I am grateful to all of them. This was possible because of the collective venture of all these people of goodwill.
Everyone who we've asked for help has been quite extraordinary. Okay, so I would call out the Jesuits especially. You know, I don't think I've ever looked at the people that I work with. You know, you'd look at Father Victor or Father Melvin or Father Guntipalli. I think that they're like some buddy of mine who, you know, I mean, like totally let's do, and they're also saying let's do more. You know, Azim Premji Foundation, oh my God, the way they funded us and the way they've supported us and the way they keep giving us ground intelligence in what we need to do. Even the governmental teams, you know, finally, you know, people have asked them to come here to survey us. They didn't have to come.
This whole exercise has helped us to understand the unity and harmony which exists in every Indian heart, irrespective of our differences.
This crisis has helped us to grow in the realization that irrespective of our individual differences, we are all one. We all belong to one human family. That spirit of oneness and collaboration is beautifully demonstrated in the work that is carried out in St. Joseph's institutions.
I feel more comfortable working with the lay partners such as this Diyagar, and I could see the different varieties of youngsters coming together and reaching out to this cause. So I would like to thank Father Francis Gundipalli and team, and especially Vishal and Arpana, for their leadership, which makes us more comfortable and also more human.
I think humanity is the greatest asset. When we care, we win. And we also bring great importance to the livelihood of many.
What matters most is to reach out to the needy and the helpless in time of emergency like this. This is just a beginning, and we are committed to continue it.
For further untold stories like this, subscribe to the YouTube channel and hit the bell icon for personal notification.